What is up, you guys? This is Mini Superheroes Today. And in today's video, we're throwing it back to 2016 to take a look at Doc Ock's Tentacle Trap, which is a Lego Spider-Man set under the code of 76059. Now, this set had 446 pieces and 5 minifigures, 4 of which only ever appeared in this set, which is pretty cool and makes it pretty desirable. That said, it retailed for $39.99 back in the day, but picking this up used these days, you could get it as cheap as $25, but probably more in the $40 range, more statistically accurately speaking. With that being said, let's dive in and start taking a look at the figures and see if this set has held up over the years. Alright, so for the minifigures, we of course have Spider-Man up first, and this is the early version of Spider-Man that debuted in 2012 and ran all the way through about 2018 or so. So it's not an uncommon figure by any stretch of the imagination, but he's not available in sets anymore, so he's collectible to some varying degree. He does come with a white surfboard that you put some spider stickers on, and we'll see how that ties in a little later in this review. Here is the White Tiger minifig, which is a cool minifig in its own right, but I always felt like it was such an odd inclusion in this set. I'm pretty sure she's a pretty big character in the Ultimate Spider-Man cartoon, but that was a little past my prime, so I haven't seen that cartoon. But the hair piece is just kind of this like rubbery piece that sticks into the hole of her head. The problem is it doesn't stick in there very well, so if you play with your figures, you would definitely want to be careful with that. She does have the Black Panther horns, as I like to call them, of course, in white, and those look very cool. And all in all, it's a very nice figure, but not too terribly much to say about it. Here we have Police Captain Stacy, and of course this is Gwen Stacy's father. It's always interesting to me that we got her dad before we actually got Gwen Stacy as a figure, of course that being Spider-Gwen, but I just always thought that was interesting. Technically, we still haven't gotten a Gwen Stacy figure, you know, out of the costume. Anyways, we're not talking about her, we're talking about her dad. So he has the cool kind of receding hairline hair that we saw from Doctor Who originally. The head is from Doc Brown from the Lego Back to the Future set, so lots of Doc pieces here. Of course, we have a police torso and just some black legs, and if we flip that hair around, he's kind of got a shocked face, which I think works really well, and I really like the fact that it's a rare head used for this figure. I just always thought that was such a cool inclusion. And speaking of classic looks, we also have Dr. Octopus, who is the namesake of this set. Now, this is a classic look for Doc Ock, of course, with those dull molded legs. It makes for a really great figure, but this is the only time we've gotten this version of Doc Ock. So I think it's cool that this set had a lot of exclusives. Pretty much everybody except for Spider-Man was exclusive. Again, I love those dull molded legs. The torso looks great. And then, of course, we do have these arms here, and the idea is that you pull these arms off, and then the black peg you see here, well, this part is supposed to stay in there, actually. It came out the wrong way, but this gray part is supposed to go into the mech in the back. I actually own two of this set, so I have the arms on the back as well as on here. I just thought it'd be easier to show you that way, but the arms are the traditional Doc Ock arms that have all of the kind of pivot joints there, and then we do have these ball joints on the hands, if you will. Kind of open those up so that they can move around. I really like these arms, but they are not my favorite as it comes to Doc Ock. So it is a cool figure, but just, you know, not my favorite. As for the set itself, we get a little police boat here, which of course does not actually float. And then we get Spider-Man with a web here so that, you know, the police boat can have him surf along. It's kind of an interesting thing, but a little bit childish and cartoony for my taste. We do get a police sticker on the side, on both sides that is, and then a nice little sticker here for a control module. There's area up front that you could put, you know, a minifig or something, and then a stud shooter here, which I guess is supposed to be like a flare with that red stud, but anyways, not a lot to the police boat build, but it is still pretty cool in its own miniature right. And then, of course, we have Doc Ock's Tentacle Behemoth, which is just this massive robot that's just so all-out cartoony, and if you're into that, this is definitely a cool set for you, I would venture to say. So I think that this is a very cool set in that regard, but again, I don't really love the cartoony stuff. But as I mentioned, you can go ahead and take these arms off of Doc Ock and put them onto the tentacle trap itself, which is something I don't necessarily like because I like the fact that Doc Ock is kind kind of like bound to his arms. I don't like the fact that, you know, it can come off even in the context of a Lego set, but you'll see there's a little knob up here, and when you turn it, the arms move. So that is a pretty cool play feature in and of itself. The entire top section here is built on a pivot that can turn side to side. And then, of course, these legs are posable on the bottom, but I think the effect is supposed to be like it hovers, because if you see under there, you've got all these green studs. So it is kind of cool in that regard, but really not too terribly much to say. There is a little clip back here if you wanted to clip his arms on the back as well. You know, he's got that little back piece here, so you could take that off and put that on there. There's a little computer module here, nothing much to say there. And then, of course, there are these stud shooters, and when you twist these cannons in the back, it shoots out a stud. So, really, not too terribly much to say. It's really more of a fun, nostalgic thing to look back at than, like, some legendary Lego set, but at least the minifigs are cool. So, with that being said, let's zoom out, and I'll give you my final thoughts. Alright guys, well I hope you enjoyed this review. If you did, don't forget to hit like and subscribe down below, and I will see you guys on the next video. If you liked what you saw and you liked what you heard, feel free to click that subscribe button for more LEGO videos coming in the near future.